Hey, let's start with the question. So, in this image, what type of cells are being depicted? And looks like most of you said erythrocytes, aka red blood cells. So, the people who said red blood cells, you're correct. So, those are erythrocytes. So, when we're talking about blood type, we're talking about erythrocytes. So, we're talking about red blood cells. Now, there are other red blood cells. So the interesting thing about leukocytes is that they have many different types of what we call antigens on their surface and platelets. But again, of your formed elements, love the cells in your blood, which make up the vast majority of the cells. These ones right here, these red blood cells. So this is why they're the most important determinant of your blood type. So in this class and in most AMP beginners classes, we just focus on what you call ABO and sometimes RH blood type. But for this class, we use ABORH. So you should, if you are taking the lab, your lab also uses the same one. So what we have here with the ABO blood types, so this is the OpenStax version. What you see is that on these red blood cells, you have all these little things protruding on the surface of the red blood cells. These are called antigens. And what is an antigen? Well, it has to deal with these things. Antigens are related to these things we call antibodies. And we did briefly go over what antibodies are earlier in the semester. So now we have to talk a little more about these proteins we call immunoglobulins or antibodies. So this is a very cartoony version, simplified version, because if you, again, it's depending on the deep level of detail you need. But again, when we're talking about antibodies, or if you hear people talking about antibodies, we're talking about immunoglobulins. And hey, this is why you call it immunoglobulins. They're globulins that your immune system uses. So antigens, so this is something that can cause a substance that can cause an immune response. It can be a protein, it can be a carbohydrate, it can be a lipopolysaccharide. Technically, the thing is, your antibodies are made out of proteins. Proteins are made out of chemicals and atoms. So any chemical that can be bound to by an antibody can be an antigen. It doesn't have to be necessarily a protein. It can be a carbohydrate. It can be any source of chemicals. So antigen in general is something that can cause an immune response that generates antibodies. So the one way you can think about it, antigens, antibody generating. So it's a substance that can be and generate antibodies. So again, antigens are not the same as an antibody. Antigens bind to and fit onto, or antibodies fit onto antigens. So again, they're not the same thing. Antibodies and antigens are different. Okay, so then antibody, if you want to be a very simplified version. So again, the antibodies has this overall structure. So why does it look like a Y in this cartoon? Well, if you look at an even more slightly more detailed version of an antibody, you notice that the binding surface here, so the antibody is like it has two arms, and here's this little trunk. It's actually made out of four polypeptides, and two of them are what is called the heavy chain, and this is the light chain, and it's symmetrical, so it has bi yeah, so the heavy chains are identical, and the light chains are identical, but they're just arranged like in pairs. So there are two binding surfaces, so it's like an antibody has two arms and two hands to grab onto surfaces. So these binding surfaces are like these parts right here of the antibody, they're like the arms. The binding surface is like the hands and fingers that allow an antibody to grab onto an antigen. And this is a little more detailed. So what we're seeing in this structure is each lump is, or each little sphere is an atom. So antibodies are polypeptide made from polypeptides, four polypeptides in fact. So what we're seeing here is the long protein chains, and they're forming this 3D structure on the right. Think about antibodies is that they recognize what we call epitopes on antigens. So epitopes are specific parts of antigens that bind to an antibody. So notice that this surface of the antigen here, this isn't actually binding to the antibody. It's the part that fits into this little pocket of the antibody. This is actually what's being bound to. So this is what we call an epitope. And the thing is, this is how do they bind? They bind via chemical bonds. So it can be things like hydrogen bonds, ionic bonds, or I think, or even like van der Waals forces. Oh, it's been a long time since basic chemistry. But the thing is that in order for antibody to be effective in binding an antigen, it needs to form chemical bonds with this antigen. So it's not going to necessarily be covalent bonds, it's going to be a combination of many different chemical bonds at that site between the antibody and the antigen. So here's another depiction of a sample antibody and antigen. And the antigen here is the red. And what we see here is the antibody only binds to it on a certain site. And again, you have this other surface of the antigen that's not being fit or that doesn't fit onto the antibody. All right, so then again, antibodies are proteins, and this is why there are. So now I think your OpenStax does have this image. And again, they're made of polypeptides, and this is why these antigen binding sites are identical. Even though they're colored different, these heavy chains are identical in the same antibody, and these light chains are identical as well. So this part right here, well, should I go over constant region? Maybe not so much for this class, but when you go on to more advanced classes, they might talk about this FC region. But the variable region, this is what changes between different antibodies. And if we have time later on in the semester, we might talk about why the variable region is variable. So pretty much in this this constant region is always the same between different types of antibodies. But this variable region is how you're able to generate different antibodies to different types of antigens. So you change this part right here. You change the genetic sequence and the gene to an mRNA to make this protein. And then you can basically generate a large amount of combinations that allow you to make a very, very large amount of antibodies that differ.